Next, the Golden Goggles for Perseverance, presenting one of my first swimmer crushes from back in the day. NBA Inside Stuff, anybody? No, nobody? Sandblast on MTV? That stuff's not even in the prompter. This is for real. Anyway, I hope she hears me. At the 1992 Barcelona Games, she was the golden girl of the team and racing to 4 medals, including a gold in the 200 fly. Joining her at the 1976 Olympics in Montreal, he was the leading man among the most successful men in Olympic history. So ladies and gentlemen, please welcome 4-time Olympic medalist Summer Sanders and 5-time Olympic medalist, for them gold, John Neighbor.
I have not heard sandblast in a really long time, but there's some people that watch me. Thanks, dude. Thank you. There's some people that remember me from Figure It Out, which I talked to a few about that. Slime? Yes. Thank you. Big moment. We have the honor of introducing and awarding the Perseverance Award. And I'm really honored to be here with my friend John Neighbor. My dad grew up in the San Fernando Valley, and he ran track. And his hero was Louis Zamperini. I got the chance to meet him in 2000 for the first time, and then he was here 4 years ago at the Golden Goggles, and I was so excited to introduce him from the audience to everybody as the truest hero in the most perfect definition of a hero. John has knew Louis Zamperini for 30 years, and I think he fits Perseverance to the T. So what is your story?
No question about it. How many of you were here 4 years ago and remember Louis Zamperini coming to stage? He was, even to this day, the only presenter to ever receive a standing ovation at the Golden Goggles.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. And I got a great story. If you're willing to go 1 minute off script, we'll tell you a real quick story. In fact, Tay, why don't you come on up here, because I need you to stand next to me for this. I had the privilege of knowing Louis for 30 years, and Louis donated a lot of his time to a lot of different charities. You may remember him from the book Unbroken and the movie Unbroken.
Yes.
But that movie only covered his life until 1948. The man I knew for 30 years was not in the movie because he was a totally different man. And when he was 89 or 90, he had the chance, Tay Collins, come on up here. Where are you? Tay is a friend of mine, a Hollywood screenwriter, who set up a lunch with me and Louis and John Wooden and Tay Collins. And the four of us sat and we talked at the Beverly Hills Hotel for about an hour. And then afterwards, we're walking to our car for lunch, and Tay, gorgeous blonde, puts her arm around Louis and she says, let's do a little foot race to the car. So Louis looks to me and says, okay, John, get us started. So I say, on your marks, get set, go. And the two of them run to the car, and I'm very gentleman, I call it a dead heat, perfect tie. And Tay puts her arm around Louis and she says, you know, Louis, if you were just 10 years younger, and she winks at him, and without beating an eye, Louis looks back at her and he says, if I was 10 years younger, you might be too old for me.
It's awesome.
And it's a story Louis doesn't like me to tell because he told me afterwards, don't tell anybody that. I said, why not? It makes you funny. It makes you clever. He says, well, there might be a 40-year-old woman in the audience who gets her feelings hurt.
Aww.
He was funny. He was charming. And it was delightful. So we honor Louis today with this award, the Perseverance Award.
Yes, we do. It's amazing. Give her a big round of applause.
That woman is here. And I was calling her up. We'll talk to her later, maybe.
She's not listening to you. Right. Our first nominee is a breaststroker who has long displayed an awesome talent, but it hasn't come easy on the international stage for Kevin Cordes. This summer in Kazan, his perseverance paid off with a 4-medal performance, which included an eye-catching silver medal swim in the 200 breaststroke.
Your next nominee, Connor Yeager, has been a fixture on the U.S. national team for years, a distant star who's always in the hunt. At the World Championships in Kazan, he delivered the swim of his career in the 1500 meters, racing to silver and breaking an 11-year-old American record, the only male to break an American record at this year's championships.
Finally, there is Allison Schmidt. After her stunning success at the 2012 Games in London, Schmidty spent some post-Olympic years struggling to regain her form. In 2015, she re-announced herself as a presence on the world stage with a gold medal performance in the 200 freestyle at the Pan American Games.
Kevin Cordes, Connor Yeager, Allison Schmidt, your nominees for the 2015 Perseverance Award.
Oh, just as a swim inside, we are tried out, we hold on so tight. after setbacks over the past 2 years, Kevin Cordes bounced back in 2015 with strong performances in Kazan. He earned 4 medals, a gold, 2 silvers, and a bronze.
And Cordes gets the bronze!
Connor Yeager just missed the medal podium in his first 2 races in Kazan, but came back on the final night to nab a hard-earned silver medal in the 1500 free, and his first American record.
Connor Yeager with a silver.
He broke the American record by 4 seconds, and that is an old record.
For the last few years, Allison Schmidt has battled with depression, affecting her in and out of the pool. In 2015, she began to speak out about it publicly, helping her on the road to recovery.
She's going to win Pan Am gold, coming to the wall, and that is a Pan Am record for Allison Schmidt.
And the winner is Allison Schmidt.
To make sure I got it all out. Okay. Thank you so much for this award, as well as the pouring amount of support I've received throughout this past year. I know if it wasn't for my friends and family, my coaches and teammates, my sponsors and fans, I wouldn't be standing here today. I'm very honored to be accepting this award, but I also have only begun to scratch the surface of both dealing with depression and to bringing awareness to mental health. Depression is something that many of us experience, but few of us ever want to make real. I have the goals to stop that stigma and help save lives in the process. Standing up here in front of a group of very successful elite athletes, I understand how competitive we get. I understand that the highs can be high, as well as the lows can be low. But what I vow to never take for granted again is the value of this precious gift of life. I've experienced depression firsthand, and I've also seen how quickly life can be taken away. My driving force is April Boshin, my 17-year-old cousin, who is beautiful, funny, and very successful athlete, who lost her battle to depression this past May. That was the first time I was able to comprehend. Sorry, got some tears. I was able to comprehend and see that depression is real. I brought my aunt here tonight to assure her that April's spirit will still stay alive through it all. Mental illness is real. It's an injury. An injury that may not be physical or even seen from outsiders, but it is real. I stand up here today with hopes that in the future, we, as elite athletes, receive the same post-Olympic mental health support in the same manner that we receive physical support day in and day out in training. I hope to bring light to the subject of mental health and destigmatize the social negativity around mental illnesses in psychologists. If me speaking out saves just one life, then I know it was worth it. Thank you again for picking me for this award, because I know in my heart that my voice is being heard. Thank you. you.
That was great. That was terrific. Very well-earned honors for Allison Schmidt. She's a winner.